government is focused on improving the country's political stability. When we say sustainable economic development, it means that it is development that aims to satisfy the needs of the humans, in this case the Filipinos, in a manner that sustains natural resources and the environment for the future generation. We define political stability as the durability and integrity of a current government budget. Let us remind you that we are talking about the Philippines and what factor is most helpful for its economy. During the World Economic Forum, it has been implied that expectations are high for East Asian governments to provide not only better infrastructure, but also political stability to spur greater economic growth. And according to Muhammad Chatib Basri, an Indonesian finance minister, the first thing we need to do is ensure political stability. He said also that political stability will allow reforms to push through and at the same time attract more investors. The reasons why businesses and investors who are very important in contributing to our economy is that they need the cooperation of a stable and organized government in the process of acquiring the factors of production that they need, like land. And once they get the permits and licenses to operate in certain regions, they invest a lot of money in setting up facilities in certain regions, which can again contribute to our economy. These facilities then provide employment or labor that the Filipinos need. Moreover, political instability hurts them as employees may skip work due to strikes, rallies, and protests that are caused by political instability against the government. And these businesses like places that are stable and beneficial, not like hostile and unfriendly expansion. The point here is that political instability hurts them from profits to operations to the working conditions of the employees, and hence businesses avoided. And with less business here in the Philippines, then less economic growth and development. Moreover, we firmly believe that the political stability is the core, or rather the seed that we all need for the other factors to function well. This is because we believe that with political stability, the citizens will trust the government well, and with this trust from the people to the government, rallies and revolutionary groups will increase or lessen. Second, with the political stability, the government will be able to implement the constitution well in a better way. And lastly, with higher political stability, this means that with higher development, economic development rather, this will provide enough funds for the facilities for scientific research that we need. In conclusion, the government reflects the people and the country. And with a stable and good government, the government will be able to attend to the needs of the people and like jobs, money and education. And with this, this will result in higher economic development.
Before anything else, I'm going to define the economy. The economy is a social institution that is primarily concerned about the proper allocation of scarce resources to satisfy unlimited human needs and wants. According to the 2014 International Monetary Fund statistics, the Philippine economy is the 39th largest in the world and is also one of the emerging markets. We believe that the government should focus on amending the economic provisions of the Constitution in order to improve the country's economy. By definition, a constitution is an established set of rules by which a state or other organization is governed. It is the most basic law from which all other laws are derived. The Philippine government cannot function properly without the constitution. Just like how Christians have the Bible, the government has the constitution. It acts as its guide or manual in running the country. Our country's economy relies on the government to provide a healthy and safe environment for the circular flow of our money. Without the Constitution, there would be no restrictions, causing chaos not only in our economy, but most especially our entire nation. Our laws would not be for the general welfare of the citizens and would only be based on the personal advancement of the lawmakers. We are now living in the age of information and technology. Changes have to be made if we want our country to be globally competitive in a constantly growing market. There is a provision in our constitution which states that a foreign investor cannot own real properties like land in the country unless forming a partnership with a Filipino citizen. Moreover, the foreign investor will only get 40% of the share and the remaining 60% will go to the Filipino citizen. If we want to entice more foreign investors into our country, we have to amend this provision by relaxing its restrictions. These foreign investors will then open up businesses in the country and contribute to our budgets to GDP, or businesses need more job opportunities and less unemployment, contributing to a higher GNI. In addition, there will be a transfer of new technology and thus an overall boost in our economy. In conclusion, we should focus on amending the economic provisions of our constitution in order to address the economic problems of poverty, unemployment, and migration. We should start now and not later.
Good afternoon, everyone. Science and technology simplifies life. Science has aided us in accomplishing our tasks more efficiently and conveniently in shorter time. Through technology, communication has been made easier, not just within families and within businesses, but also between countries all over the world. With the discoveries of inventions, such as computers and machines, we paved the way for greater career, health, and industrial opportunities. Technology is highly popular and economically growing. There are a multitude of inventions we humans greatly depend on to sustain our existence. In the case of education, teachers now make use of multimedia for teaching instead of boards and charts, and don't make use of LCD projectors for better learning. In business, computers help with new business information in time and in one place. In the field of medicine, most lengthen our life expectancy, reduce our rate of infant mortality, and has produced medical technologies which are very helpful in the detection and prevention of diseases and illnesses. With biomedical research and inventions and the unending efforts of our scientists, many sicknesses such as malaria, tuberculosis, and cancer, which were considered incurable, have now been found curable. The discovery of mechanization, better irrigation, and pest control techniques has worked to increase farm productivity. Railways, modern ocean liners, planes, and motor vehicles have made our lives more comfortable and has provided us with greater possibilities for modern commercial development and industrialization. Science has predicted natural disasters and weather conditions that could potentially save thousands of lives. Here are some important scientific discoveries and breakthroughs: gravity, electricity, the periodic table, pasteurization, penicillin, DNA, clothing, mechanics, sewage disposal, water purification, and food preservation. Economists have agreed over the years that a large component of modern economic growth is gained from innovation. Productivity is the result of innovation. In the UK, scientists have called on their government to support science as a means of helping the economy out of recession. Governments in Germany, Sweden, Canada, Britain, and Australia have started increasing their funds for science and technology as part of stimulus packages designed to aid their struggling economies. Economies which lag in incorporating new technologies are considered poor and underdeveloped countries. Their progress in the world is hindered. Scientific research promotes economic growth, innovation, development, and the improvement of individuals. Scientific history tells us that these breakthroughs ultimately lead to major economic gains in the coming years. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We believe that these four factors are important in helping our economy grow. However, when it comes to prioritizing which non-economic factor should be dealt first, we believe that peace and order should come first. Why peace and order? First of all, peace and order is the precondition in attaining economic growth, meaning peace and order should be focused first by the nation in order for the other three non-economic factors, scientific breakthrough, constitution, and political stability, to follow and emerge. First of all, we would like to define what is economic growth. For us, economic growth is not just about investors in our country, but also those investors from other countries, because their businesses also matter to that country. But the problem is, they can't have businesses here because people here are scared. They are scared that their workplace here is dangerous. This is why peace and order is important. Peace is the state of being free from any kind of human conflict and violence. All the activities of a country run smoothly in the situation of peace. Peace is a sign of development and prosperity. Human rights are not violated. People can walk freely from one place to another without having any fear in mind. They can do their business without any obstruction. People respect each other and each other's rights. they are also committed to fulfill their duty toward their society. Rule and order is respected by all. People can raise their living standard by working hard. Peace brings happiness among people. They are involved in development activities. Peace helps to promote human rights, democratic norms, and values. Peace helps to create the feeling of love, trust, tolerance, and brotherhood among people. Development process can't go ahead without peace and harmony. Peace is the mother of civilization, and war is the demon of destruction. Civilization and development cannot progress if there is no peace in the country. Literature flourishes only in the time of peace. It is also the case with philosophy, science, industry, and art. In our daily lives, we also find interest and pleasure in doing work in times of peace. In times of war, its energy and resources are all employed in defense. So once again, in order for the other three non-economic factors to flourish, peace and order must be dealt first to attain economic growth.